No, lo voy a hacer ahora. Okay, I'm going to give you the question, okay? So I will give you the question because you don't know what you have to say. I'm going to give you the question and then I will play the gong. And then you will start. And I will play the gong after a minute and then the other person will reflect. And then after a minute, and the other person will give a little gift to the person in front of her. All right? As I said, you don't have to share anything personal if you don't want to. All right? Okay? Question. Has this meditation practice helped you to discover something new? I will ask the same question again. Has this meditation practice helped you to discover something new? Mirror. Now, what you have to do is to, the person who has been the mirror continues speaking and shares a little epiphany, a little gift that she has discovered while actively listening. Okay? So something that the other person has been explaining that has resonated inside, you share. Thank you. Okay, only one of you has been listened to. Let's do the other way around, okay? Do you need me to repeat the question? Yes? Has this meditation practice helped you in some way to discover something new? This is the question. Again, I want to see these active listening techniques. So always make sure that you're not waiting for the other person to speak, to put your ideas on what the person is saying. Just listen. Openness, loving kindness. Do you remember beginner's mind? Okay. Mirror now. Mirror, reflection. Mirror what the person said. Time now to tell the other person something that that person has said that has resonated within you. Do it. Okay, it's time now. It's time now. to finish this active listening activity by looking directly into the eyes of the person with whom you did this activity. Thank this person just by looking at this person's face. Don't look at me. Look at this person, don't speak, just smile and breathe with this person. Just be there. Thank you for doing this.
Yes, we haven't finished yet. We need 5 more minutes, and we promise this is going to be the end. Okay, one of the goals of this workshop was to teach you how to, and I'm not going to say spend, but waste your time wisely. Well, if you look at this light, you will see a compass and a watch. This is a pocket watch, a pocket clock. Well, the point is that we are made of time and memories, but time is a limited resource. And we have to spend it the best way we can before our life comes to an end. It's crazy, I know it's crazy, but there are ways to make the most of time. These were questions that we want to pose to you. These are questions we want you to ask yourselves. How much time do you spend doing things that really matter to you? How much time do you spend with the people that you love? What prevents you from devoting more time to really important things, to really important people in your life? And well, think of ways to make the most of your precious time. That's homework for you. We are not going to do that. Well, the point is that according to Stephen Covey, there are ways to make the most of our time. And he says that there are 4 quadrants. There are things which are urgent and important, urgent and non-important, non-urgent and not important, sorry, unimportant, and not urgent and not important. Well, if you look at these 4 quadrants, we should make a huge effort to spend most of our time on quadrant number 2. Things which are not urgent, but are important, nevertheless. We should avoid spending time on quadrants 3 and 4, because those are really a waste of time. So we should try to avoid spending time on 3 and 4, or limit the time we spend on these 2. And well, quadrant 1 is important. It's urgent, it's important, so we should manage it the best way we can. But remember to reserve some little time for quadrant number 4. Not urgent and important things that we tend to procrastinate because we spend most of our time doing things like this, and those are a waste of time. So manage quadrant number 1, focus on quadrant number 2.
We have prepared a final meditation if you want to be with us. If you don't, because you're tired or because you have to go, that's okay. But this workshop is based on, we were talking about butterflies. So I have prepared a short meditation based on butterflies. If you want to stay with us, you're very welcome. It is going to be a very short one, and the way of saying goodbye. I'm going to ask you, if you still have your pebbles, I'm going to ask you to, your stones, If you don't have your stones, you can have the stones from this blue bag. And I'm going to ask you to put the pebbles on the floor. One pebble. On the floor. Okay, Leonor, maybe you can leave the photocopies there and they can take them when they leave if they want. Okay. Can you close the door and put the lights down? Are your pebbles on the floor? Adopt the meditating posture. As we come together to the end of this training week, it is a perfect moment to listen now to your inner self actively. Let me invite you to go to your breath, to go back to this unfailing breath, which is with you since you were born. And be with it. And now, imagine the most beautiful butterfly you have ever seen. It can be Austin's butterfly. It can be any butterfly you want to think of. Picture its shape, its size. How many colors can you imagine in her wings? Are these brilliant colors? Which pattern do you find in her wings? Is this beautiful butterfly small? Is it big? Butterflies are a great metaphor for what we've been doing in this workshop. The expression to have butterflies in your stomach refers to an emotion. The butterfly pose or the butterfly asana refers to a posture in yoga, which is also an important meditative practice. But above all, this beautiful, magical butterfly that you have imagined is the end result of what we are. We are caterpillars, actually. We are caterpillars now. What we have been doing in this week is to actively plant a seed in our caterpillar capsule, to plant a seed deep in our hearts, in our mind, in our breathing bodies. Can you feel the seed? As we say farewell today, observing how you're slowing and silently transforming into that beautiful and majestic butterfly. When you are ready to stretch your magical wings and to beat them to fly, this transformation will be seen within yourself. But also that this transformation will be seen, will be felt by those around you. You will soon make a difference. You will soon start a revolution in your daily lives and in the lives of all those to whom you strongly influence every day. Your students, your workmates, your family, your friends. Past butterflies posing recalls that magical moment when a butterfly, when you stop the beating of your colorful but fragile wings. May you be these butterflies soon. May you be these butterflies soon. May you be these butterflies soon. And now, take these pebble seeds with you and transform yourselves. Thank you.